The London 2012 archery began with two world records as Im Dong-hyun, who's so short-sighted he's legally blind, posted 699 from 72 arrows, and South Korea recorded a world best score for a team of three. The main competition was held on the outfield of the famous Lord's Cricket Ground. The hoped-for amphitheatre atmosphere was most in evidence when British archers such as Larry Godfrey were shooting.
The crowd here are absolutely fantastic. This is definitely the best arena I've ever shot in and competed in. And on home soil, do you know what? It's a privilege to be here.
And the standards were high. They shoot from 70 metres, and the 10 is about the size of a grapefruit. This is the USA's Katuna Lorig producing the perfect shot and taking out the camera in the centre of the target. Don't worry, she still scored a 10. The final of the men's team event was USA versus Italy. It came down to the last shot. Italy's Michele Frangilli would tie with a 9. 10 would mean gold.
10 points.
Italy had upgraded their Beijing silver to the biggest prize of all. The weather didn't always hold up. This was the women's team final, South Korea versus China. South Korea's women's teams have been utterly dominant since the event was introduced into the Olympics in 1988. They'd won 6 out of 6 gold medals. But this was another close finish. Ki Bo-Bae, who'd finished top in the ranking round, had to deliver. 9 for gold.
9 for gold.
And South Korea were champions again. There'd been early shocks in the women's individual rounds, but Ki was still standing at the end. Her final against Mexico's Aida Rahman came down to a 1-arrow shoot-off. Nearest the center wins, and Ki fired first.
8.
What a chance for Rahman. Chance missed. Ki was a double Olympic champion. A great achievement for a 24-year-old who was missing her dad.
She wants to say I love you to her dad, who did his best to teach her archery, and she wants to go back home and see him.
The one archery medal no South Korean had ever won was the men's individual, and there was great disappointment for their fans when Im, who'd done so well in the ranking round, was beaten heavily in the last 16 by Rick van den Ven of the Netherlands. Kim Bub-min also fell before the final, and so Oh Jin-Hyek carried South Korean hopes of gold against Takaharu Furukawa of Japan. Oh kept his nerve and scored a resounding win to become the first South Korean to take the men's individual Olympic title.